In the past, we were very confident of our R&D capabilities and thought that our products, whether in terms of specifications or quality, are better than our competitors. Therefore, we became complacent, did not self-assess, and in the end, we did not even know if our customer needed us. We did not even know if our consumers needed us. We thought our products were of a high quality, so after this crisis, everyone in the entire office calmed down and assessed themselves. I discovered that there are two different problems. Firstly, we did not understand what kind of products our end consumers desired. Secondly, we did not see or treat our distributors or resellers as partners. We tried 2 years of so-called branding, only to discover that we did not fully understand what brand management entails. Now when we see that our distributors or resellers have excess inventory, we will send our marketing team to understand the problems they are facing when selling our products. Are our competitors slashing prices, or are there other reasons? Regardless of the reasons, we will try our best to think of a solution. Actually, when we talk about global marketing, we may still have some disillusions. We may think that we should fulfill what the world needs when we roll out the desired design, hoping that this one product will sell around the world. However, what global marketing actually means is that manufacturers need to localize their products. Consumers in different regions have different needs. Inventory control is the critical aspect of brand management. Others may think that excess inventory is caused by the factory, but in fact, excess inventory is caused by the discrepancy between what the front-end consumers want and what you have manufactured. Perhaps our distributors are not doing a good job selling. So do not just assess your inventory. Go forward, see what consumers want, discover the real problems that your distributors and resellers face, and find the solutions. This is how you can solve this problem. Another important element is improving talent. We established another marketing team to understand our consumers' need before starting to design our product. After achieving this information, we will then have discussions with our R&D team, resulting in us developing products that consumers really want. However, our responsibility does not end the moment our products are released to the market. You may think that you have manufactured products that consumers want, but the experience that your consumers have when using your products is extremely important too. The user interface, normally complemented by computers, creates the problem of impression. This is an after-sales service problem, so for true marketing, you have to review the entire process starting from what consumers need until the time that they start using your products. Then you can truly sell through your products and not only sell to.